The next commentary session. The topic for the session is careers of future. So our esteemed speaker for the session is Mr. Ram Shivalinga. Mr. Ram Shivalinga graduated from Peck in 2010 from the Department of E&I. He is presently a corporate strategist in constructions, entertainment, and education verticals for my home group, Hyderabad. It was indeed a pleasure to introduce you, sir. I respectfully hand over the platform to you.
Hi, Rahul. Thank you. Thanks for a generous introduction. So I'm presuming the audience is largely our college students. So that's where I would take it off from. I wish I could see them, but yeah, I'm presuming it's the same, right, Rahul? It's our
yes,
college
sir. School,
largely. Yeah, great.
Sir.
Guys, I'm not sure how many of you are there. That's the good and bad of the virtual world. So let me start off with what I was planning to talk about is some new jargon which is going around these days, largely in the corporate world. So it could be even the fourth revolution, industrial revolution that people are talking about. It's about mobiles not being existing, smartphones not being existing 5 years down the line. So there are a lot of changes which keep it happening, and that's probably the theme of my talk. So I've read a good book, I think during the BTech times only, written by Alvin Toffler. So it's called The Future Shock. I would strongly recommend all of you to just go through that once. So it just talks about how quickly the world is changing. And today's theme, I think, is all about how quickly do we adapt and how quickly, how agile are we to adapt to the new circumstances that are coming around. So be ready to change. That's the single line theme that I would talk about in terms of the future careers, because they are not the careers of today. Are people predict that in the next 5 to 10 years, at least 50% of them will not be existing. AI might take over or any other new machine might take over what the work we are doing. And I think this has been a theme since the last 20 years, probably not just today, but the rate at which it is changing is much higher. So you see, there are technologies which markets are skipping. For example, pager never even entered into India. It was it just came from the landline phone to we just jumped onto the smartphones. And I'm sure there's a good generation of Indians who has not even seen a regular phone, but have just jumped to a smartphone, skipping even the future phone. So there are a lot of technological changes that are happening, and we need to be adapt to that. So one way I would say where you can categorize in terms of, so there are three things that I'll talk about quickly. So the first one is the ABCDs of the future. So when people talk about the first, and these are the four sectors that you can choose from. So one is AI, artificial intelligence, stands for A. Then the B stands for blockchain, C stands for cloud computing, and D stands for data. So these are the four things that people talk about which drive the future across the sectors, across the industries. So being an engineer, being a technology person, I think we need to focus on all of these four and see where we can adapt and where we can get better with them. So that's the four. Repeating again, artificial intelligence, blockchain, cloud computing, and data. So the next one I would want to talk about is choose your sector wisely. So you might want to be a software engineer, you might want to be a mechanical engineer, you might want to be a construction engineer. So whatever it is, also have a view on your sector that you want to finally live with. So when I meant that, I meant education is a sector, so health is a sector, food as a sector, construction or infrastructure as a sector, farming or agriculture as a sector. So there are various sectors, be it transport or so on. So I would say spend a little more time on which sector do you want to settle up with and plan your career accordingly. So there are sectors which are evergreen, which always are needed. There are sectors which are vanishing by the day as we speak. So choose them wisely is the second theme that I want to talk on. The third theme that I want to talk on is the skills that are required. So what are we talking about? Earlier, people were talking about core construction skills, but today the soft skills are sort of dominating over the hard skills. And even in the hard skills, there are certain skills which people are expecting a little more. Some of the skills could be like the Forbes is talking about the top five skills that are needed, and they talk about emotional intelligence. So these days, a lot of people are lacking the judgment skills in terms of what is right, what is wrong, and what is right in that particular period of time, and how do we balance between both. And I think not only at a professional level, but even at a personal level, this is very important. It's very important to know what is right and how do you take it forward. So first thing, guys, I would suggest you to build your emotional intelligence. That's one of the core skills. The second one that we're talking about is creativity. So when I talk about creativity, it's not just creativity is not limited to art or entertainment sectors, but creativity is there in every day of our work. How differently do it, how intelligently. So you take any business for that matter, any engineer for that matter, all of us appreciate when someone does differently and something great. So that basically means creativity. So all of us should be more creative. That's the second core skill that is needed for the future. The third skill that they talk about is flexibility and adaptability. This, I think, is one of the very important skills, because today, as I started the talk with, the theme of tomorrow basically is about how quickly do you adapt and change to what is requested for. Because I remember one of my colleagues who joined Google, I think 4 years back. So she joined as a campaign manager. So that means she manages all the YouTube, Facebook, every campaigns. So we again met, I think, on this note 2 years back or 1.5 years back. And within 2.5 years, she told, Ram, my looks like my role is not going to exist in Google in the future. She's like, what happened? So her view was, whatever they were doing, 90% of the work is automated. So there is no need for a physical person to be there. And how did they do it? Through AI. So they learned what these people are taking the decisions on. They mapped all the decisions at the back end and they made that into a tool which can automatically take the decisions instead of them. So we are also talking about a lot of changes in terms of machinery getting into even in the hardcore construction area. So earlier for scaffolding to be laid, it used to take, for example, 1 month. And there were a lot of people who were involved. Today we have a Bobcat, which actually makes the process all the more easy. So you just need one ladder. So the erection time is 2 days. But we need fast speed, and that's where we go with bigger machinery, bigger technologies. We are also talking about precast. So because one of the biggest problems today for us in construction industry is labor. So even the chairman spends every day good time in finding out how many labor actually came to the site. So to avoid that, naturally, we are going to precast, which basically reduces a lot of effort in terms of sourcing people. So it's a pre-made model, which is just put up there. So that's a completely different technology, and it cuts, I think, jobs by almost 50%. So because there's not many people required at the site. Yes, there is a little employment created at the precast site. But what I'm talking about is you need to change the skill to that rather than just stay with what is available in the market and not upgrade yourself. And it's constant. The learning is always constant. We keep upgrading ourselves in terms of the skill sets, because someone who haven't, I mean, when I entered the industry, digital marketing was hardly anything. And now you see it's almost everything. So we need to be clear in terms of what exactly are the skills that are for the future. The fourth one that I will talk about is, I think Manadeep is in. Finally, I could see a person. Hi, sir.
Hi, Ram. How are you doing? Go ahead, good. Sorry.
Yeah. Yes. So the fourth skill that they were talking about is data literacy. So for the future, we are talking about it is based on data. It is based on how much analysis that we do. So that's the fourth skill they were talking about. And the fifth one that they were talking about, the last one, is critical thinking. So these are the five skills that people are talking about, which is needed for the future. So rather than I would talk about careers of the future, I thought I will start talk a little more about the skills of the future. And these five is what I believe in. So yeah, that's all from my side, Rahul. So if there are some questions, we can take it.
One of the questions is that, so keeping in view of most of the emerging careers, how would you emphasize the need of software knowledge in our education system?
Very good. So software, there are two parts to the software that I understand. I'm not sure who asked the question, but there are two parts to the software. So one is the thought process which goes, the algorithm the logic which we build in. The second part is the coding part. So not everyone is needed to get both the skills. But the first one, I think logic is something which everyone needs to have in terms of how do we take it forward. Then either you code it, that'd be great, or you can get someone else to help you on that. So software engineer is needed for the future, but it's a very wide gamut of opportunities that you're talking about. So yeah.
And sir, are the ABCDs that you told now, are they true for all the streams? And if they are true, how?
So they're largely technical, Rahul, when we talk about artificial intelligence, blockchain, cloud computing, or data. So all the four are generally for technology people. But having said that, they're impacting everyday's world. So for example, one of the presentations that I gave recently to my board was on how technology or data is changing a construction company. So we did talk about all of this. We did talk about fourth industrial revolution. We were saying we wanted to build mobile applications. So you understand a construction company getting into, at least thinking of mobile applications. So yes, these four are impacting every sector that is possible. So I would ask all of the people to keep an eye on that. And I presume that at least 60 to 70% of the audience is aspiring to be a software or a technology person.
It was indeed a very delightful session, sir. We sincerely thank you for taking out your time and supporting us by sharing your insightful thoughts.
Thank you. Thank you, Rahul.